They say that in baseball, you can't hit what you can't see, but that sure isn't true in driving. In fact, the number one cause of crashes is drivers running into things they don't see, like a car coming from the side, a pedestrian stepping into the street, or a driver changing lanes. The reason they don't see is that they just aren't looking in the right place at the right time. Experienced drivers learn the trouble spots by getting into them and mostly getting out of them. But the best way to handle trouble spots is to avoid them in the first place. This segment addresses the topic of where to look and when. Trouble can come from ahead, especially at intersections. Trouble can also come from the side. Other vehicles may be right next to you, but their drivers don't even know you're there. Trouble can come from behind, too. After a collision, it's common to hear the driver who was at fault claim, "I was looking, but I didn't see him coming." To examine the difference between looking and seeing, let's take a quick test. Take a moment to count the number of F's that appear in the following sentence on the screen. So, how many did you count? There are actually 6 F's in the sentence. Sometimes our eyes and brains automatically skip past important details if we're not careful. When you look at something, you're just aiming your eyes in a certain direction. But seeing involves fully processing what your eyes see in order to send a meaningful message to your brain. When it comes to driving, the eyes have it, but they've got to be pointed in the right direction. That's what the next segments are all about. The process of looking is referred to as a visual search. Seeing well is more than simply taking in the roadway scene. It also requires actively searching places where trouble might be lurking. To actively search, you move your eyes in a constant pattern, scanning near to far and left to right. The goal of active searching is to identify, as early as possible, anything that might require you to adjust your speed, change your position by steering, or communicate with another road user. Just looking ahead doesn't cut it. Good drivers actively search, checking to their sides and to the rear while still looking most of the time at the path ahead. But some drivers don't really see what's ahead. This is one of the two major causes of crashes. About 1 out of every 5 crashes results from a driver not paying enough attention to what's ahead. Even many experienced drivers don't realize how dangerous it is to look away from the roadway ahead for more than just a second. In fact, looking away from the road for just 2 seconds doubles your chance of having a collision. But looking ahead is only part of it. How far ahead is another. Beginning drivers tend to focus on the road just in front of the car. That doesn't give you much time to react. Keeping your eyes focused farther down the road gives you a heads up on what's happening and lets you come to a gradual, even stop. But how can you keep your car in its lane if you're looking way ahead? It turns out that if you aim your vehicle at the middle of the lane, you'll actually do less zigzagging back and forth. Looking farther ahead may feel strange at first because your instinct is probably to look at the front corners of your car, but stay with it. Looking far enough ahead will pay off every day you drive. In addition to helping you drive safely, looking well down the road can help keep you from needing to slow down or stop for other cars. And seeing that signal light turn yellow from way back gives you the time and space to come to a smooth stop. Looking ahead includes scanning the areas on both sides of the road. What's at the side of the road now may be in the road in a minute, like that truck pulling away very slowly. Seeing it up ahead gives you a chance to adjust. Not only do you need to look ahead and scan the sides of the road, but you also need to look far enough ahead. If you can, you should scan as far ahead as 20 to 30 seconds. But the area that you should focus on most is the area that is 12 to 15 seconds directly ahead. This is called your visual control zone. It includes the space you can steer into if a potential problem develops into a threatening situation. Detecting any potential problems 12 to 15 seconds ahead should give you time to adjust to whatever you see. Here on a city street, that's about 1 block. Out here, on the open road, traveling at 55 miles per hour, that would be about 1/4 mile. Unfortunately, roads don't have little lines that show 15-second intervals, so it's up to you to develop a picture in your mind's eye. When you're driving down the road, pick a point in the distance, like that sign, and start counting to 15. 1001, 1002, 1003, 1004, 1005, 1006, 1007, 1008, 1009, 1010, 1011, 1012, 1013, 1014, 1015. If you reach the sign before you reach 1015, you need to look further ahead. With a bit of practice counting distance out like this, you'll start to develop a sense of how far ahead 15 seconds is. It's okay if you don't clearly see all of the detail in the area 15 seconds ahead. The main thing is to look far enough ahead to be able to spot potential trouble and adjust early and gradually to what you can see. Most new drivers don't look far enough ahead. If there's a vehicle ahead, most of them just look at the rear of that vehicle and nothing else. Okay, let's take a drive and try out your active searching techniques. In each scene, there will be something up ahead that you'll need to react to. The picture will stop at that point, and you'll be asked what you saw. What did you see? Since there may be workers and unusual vehicles in construction zones, you should slow down and use additional caution. What did you see? The flashers told you that the car was stopped or driving slowly and you'd need to change lanes. So let's keep going. What did you see this time? Large trucks cannot accelerate as quickly as passenger vehicles. You can expect to either change lanes or slow down to avoid running into it. How about that one? Oh, that one's easy. When a school bus stops, you stop. Although some drivers may go on by, don't risk it. Where there are school buses, there are children.